Hey everybody, I am Cinnamon Cooney, your art Sherpa, and today I'd like to show you how to paint an eye realistically in acrylic painting step-by-step so that you can do this yourself at home. Everything you need to know about this painting is going to be explained, the materials, the steps, the process. I'm going to go through everything. You're going to be able to duplicate it, and I'm really excited to share it with you. Get your paint, get your brushes, grab your canvas and come back and meet me at the easel right now. We'll get started. Description below, materials, and coming up as well. All right, let's go. I'm going to sketch this in and I'm going to talk to you about how I'm doing that and why. So the first thing that I'm going to do is center in place my eye, because my eye is going to take up quite a lot of my canvas. I'm going to follow my reference photo and create my arcing line up. It's going to be very sketchy. When I'm sketching in, my method tends to be a little bit messy and furtive and tentative, even though I always kind of get it in. And that's because I've come to a place in my art practice where I don't have to be that uptight and particular. Now, that is correct for me, and that would not necessarily be correct for you. When I have my basic eye shape in, I'm going to put in my lid, and there are several types of lids, several type of eye shapes. This one that I'm using has a very low lid. If you're trying to get good at eyes, if that's something that's really important to you to get better and better and better at, having reference photos is very important. And I'll tell you something else. Watching makeup tutorials is also very helpful. I'm going to come up here and sort of sketch in this implied little eyebrow just so I sort of know what's going on here. The eyebrow arcs over. A lot of times eyebrows will start lower and come up higher up the brow bone. It's really up to you, because right now we're focusing on this structure here and I'm just placing objects. I know I've got an inner duct here. And an interesting thing that a lot of people miss is this lid, the eye is inset back a bit into a lid. And the space here is very important to the structure of the eye when you're trying to draw it in or reference it or create that feeling of realness. So I always like to know where that is. I also often will reference this curved line right here. That's because I'm going to be putting a lot of shadows here to imply that this is a round ball that's inset into this space. And now I'm going to do the colored part of the eye, the iris part of the eye. And I'm going to have it go a little bit below the lid here. And that tells me how wide the eye is open. This conveys a lot in my artwork about the state of the subject. Are they relaxed? Are they surprised? Are things funny right now for them? And we're going to really look at, in different lessons, how those different states of emotion impact this structure. I'm going to have my little circle here. I might actually move it closer to the top. There we go. That will impact where it's looking, doesn't it? And I may change this as I paint it, and you may as well. So right now what I'm looking is, how is my lid? I'm adjusting my lid to make sure that it's where I want it to be, because it's going to cast a shadow through here. So you can see how I've sketched this in. If you're working your sketching in, that's normal, and that doesn't mean that you've got something crazy going on. I'm doing this colored pencil and burnt sienna because that's going to blend in nicely to the skin tone that I've got to deal with in a minute anyways. Let's mix our skin tone. I'm going to do this number 10 bright for acrylic painting. I like to call her Goldilocks because the filaments on this bright are not soft and not too hard. They're just right for heavy body paint. I'm going to prime my brush and make sure I take off my excess water. I'm going to definitely be using my glazing medium, and I'm going to create kind of a skin tone. And how I'm going to start my skin tone is I'm going to put a little of my alizarin over here to my yellow oxide. I may have to put out some more white closer to it and start kind of pulling this out and creating a light base skin tone. If it's too bright, that's actually what the green is for, believe it or not, is to gray that out and knock that back. Makeup artists are having a good laugh about this right now. I'm going to start laying in the values around the eye. Just laying in the values around the eye. You can see that the pencil's picking up into the paint, but I have a lot of work here to do to create that sort of feeling, so I'm not that worried about it. Right now, I just want to really get my paint in there. Want to have it be somewhat skin toned. I might even add a little burnt sienna to that. And quite a lot more white. I'm just needing to put this in this sort of base that I can shade out later. And this is important in acrylic because in acrylic painting, creating this base is how you build your painting. The wonderful thing here is that I have actually quite a lot of control over what I've got going on. Maybe a little too much yellow ochre, so I'm adding some more red to that. Burnt sienna. And then a ton of the white. There we go. That's where I want to be. I'm going to just kind of try to get this all in. So that initial layer is a lot to get in, you might notice. And if you need more information on how to mix skin tones, check out the Big Art Quest, which is going to be in the description below and in the iCard. Now, I've got this base sort of general skin tone in, and this lets me start doing the tonal study to build the structure that is around my eye. I've creeped in a little bit with my flesh tone on the inner lid because I need it there. And I've kind of just been very general around, and now we're going to start really refining and designing what we've got here. If you've really struggled with eyes, I want you just to sort of hang in and really give it a go, because I think you can do it. I think you'll really surprise yourself. I'm going to switch to a number 8 bright, and I'm going to put out a little more white paint. I find anytime that I have got to do any sort of flesh tones or anything, I go through a lot more white paint. That's just me. Maybe you're different, but that is definitely what I have going on. Using my reference photo, I'm going to start blocking in areas that I think are much lighter and much darker to help create and define shape. So one of the areas that we know is going to be much lighter is the inside lid. If you guys watch makeup tutorials at all, you might have noticed that this is often highlighted. Those are very good reference materials for you. I find them really fascinating. So for sure, right here, I know I'm going to have a highlight right underneath the eye into the skin. Right? Going to have a highlight right underneath the eye into the skin. Our goal here today is not hyper-realism. It's to learn how we paint in a more realistic manner, the eye and the eye structure. And by going big, we're just taking a minute to look more closely at that. You'll notice I'm just pulling out the skin tone, right, and adding more and more white paint to it where I think that that is necessary. And enjoying my glazing medium. This is no different, honestly, than painting in black and white or sketching it in a pencil on a creative level, because what you're doing, right, is defining space using tone and value. I'm going to add a highlight up here. just letting the pigment on my brush come up here, adding white to the pigment, making sure that I've got a highlight in this upper corner. So when I define my brow in, that will actually make a big difference. What's happening there, right? Another thing that I can do is I can pull out my crimson, my burnt sienna, and I'm getting that sort of very, very dark tone. I'm going to add some ochre. You can see this. You're like, oh, it's like contouring. Yeah, it's a lot like contouring. I'm going to refine the lid shadow right now. Right now. Just refining it. Actually, a lot of this is going to be very much in shadow, but it's about building these things up. You'd be amazed at how much gray happens inside the eye. Just adding this. If I want to even increase the darkness of this, I can pull some blue over. See how it really green grays it up? And just add it here. That's crazy, I know. But actually, it's a nice way to imply a deeper shadow. Wipe my brush off, grab my glazing liquid, and blend that in. If you've ever thought to yourself, I'm really good at makeup, but I'm not really good at drawing, you may discover that you're better at it than you think. Now I'm going to pull some of this darker value, just the burnt sienna, along this lid here. And then maybe a little bit right out here. Just pulling that. See, I get the little bit of the blue in there and it starts to just tone it down. And then I can come right here, adding that. Just building up that eye structure. Let's come here and define some of this shape, the roundness of the shape. Shadow is fantastically brilliant for helping us define shape. Adding more in, and where I need to blend or glaze, I just take advantage of that tool. You know, this is a really doable skill. This isn't something you ever need to feel kind of bad about or intimidated by. I'm going to take a little of my black and put a tip of that on my brush here. You can see it's just on the tip. I'm going to my brown, add a smidge of water to improve flow, and I'm going to just start to think about softly defining this brow line. This is sort of the under brow shadowing that you might expect. I'm not going to be real particular at this stage. This part will be soft. If you think about it, it's if you have to darken or define your eyebrows with a little bit of makeup, right? We're creating this soft line, saying this is where our brow will eventually sort of sit, and apparently our model today is gonna have a brow comb. You can come back later and define much more particular, you know, hairs or things. So once I have that in, then I know I've got to have that highlight at my brow bone. So I'm going to get to my skin tone again. A little of my alizarin a little of my burnt sienna, a little oxide. I haven't rinsed it out. A lot of this white. I come right here. Make sure that I am defining this. It's not that bad. It's pretty easy. I'm doing it. Just loading up my brush so that I can blend this out, this highlight, because that's what I'm going to be working. I want to highlight this space right here is lighter. I really like to paint eyes. I enjoy them. You know, they are not generally as much work when you do them smaller. The bigger that you make the eye structure, the more you're going to have to be observant of what is happening there. Now, you'll notice I'm just lightening my, you can almost hear when I lighten my pressure of my brush, when I'm trying to shade or create subtle value changes. You know, I'm going to wipe off, pull a little more of the white out, but you can see because I have pigment on my brush, it's not ever going to be just bright white. I'm going to continue to define this highlight. And believe it or not, there's a bit of a highlight right here. We'll pull that out and round that out. Paying attention to what I'm seeing. Right? Paying attention to what I'm seeing. Where are the shadows? Where are the bright highlights? Why are they there? They generally have a reason. One's right here. It will still need more definition. It's one of those things that you just keep working it and keep working it. Now I've got my skin tone here. I'm going to take it a little more to the red. Then I'm going to get a little blue into what's happening here. That's crazy, right? But that's graying my blue. Wipe your brush off very, very, very well. Get a little of my black here. The inside of my eyeball, I really, really want to avoid being bright white. Really, really strongly do not want that. I might want that in a highlight, but I will absolutely not in general want that. So you're going to notice this has got quite a lot of blue in it. You don't want too much blue. You're not trying to make a blue sky inside the eye. You're trying to tint or tone this white. There's going to be a lot of, much like the skin that we're going to keep working, there's going to be a lot of shading. But this stage is called blocking in. Blocking in is a darn important stage. A little more black in there. This side has to be blocked in. Hopefully your reference is helping you. And a lot of this is going to be seeing what we're doing here, painting along, and then seeing if you can apply this to different references of eyes. Right? That's going to be something that you've got to think about. I'm going to rinse out my brush. I'm going to pull out some more of my flesh tone that I have here. I want it to be just a smidge pinker. And I'm going to make sure that I have this part, the inside lid, sort of painted in. Just painting it in. And I may have to paint some of that back. I'm going to get a small amount of more red. And then right here, inside here, that's going to be this base. This is going to be changed up a lot. And believe it or not, you're going to have to take some of this red and slightly dust it into the eye. There's going to be a distinctive red that you feel. A lot of the references for makeup tutorials will cause you trouble here because they'll whiten the eye of the photograph more than it would be. So one good resource, believe it or not, is medical sites that talk about different types of eye coloration. Because they won't alter the color of the eye in some way. Put the basic of this in. Which you're gonna be like, why'd you draw the pupil in when you're about to do what you're about to do? And be like, I just do this stuff. So I'm gonna take a little of my burnt over to my phthalo. Not a lot. Just enough to knock it, what we like to call knocking it back if you've never been here before. And I'm going to just paint this. And I may be adjusting all kinds of things about this eye as I go, as I look at it. When you're painting an eye and you're dealing with your reference, you may be doing the same thing. But the point is, to even get the shape of the layout, you've got to paint it in. That's all you got to do. Paint it in. Got to show up and try. That's it. Now we've just got to say, do we like what we've painted here? A little more of my burnt over to my phthalo. You're going to find in references, and we're going to address this because I think we need to have painting lessons on it, that there's a lot more references for light colored eyes than dark colored eyes. And the reason for that is that to show the drama inside the eye, the darker the eye, the better lighting equipment and better photographer you actually need to be. So a lot of times those images are super copyrighted. Whereas, you know, if you've got some good light and a decent phone camera, you know, other eyes, green eyes, might photograph easier. And that's all it is. They're all equally beautiful. They're all equally amazing. Just some are harder to photograph because of lighting. But I found some, so we'll paint some in the future. Painting in the eye. I love painting in the eye. I'm just taking this dark blue and trying to make sure that I'm covering all. Whoops, well on the lid, but I'm going to come back with the lid. Painting all my canvas. Now I'm going to have a big giant eye painting. You might have a big giant eye painting. And what are we going to do with all these big giant eye paintings? Oh no. So many eyes. So many eyes are going to be out. Flooding. Oh, it's already kind of coming together. All right. Flooding social media. Definitely share your eyeballs with me. You know, let me know what's been easy for you, what's been a challenge, what we could talk about and help you with so that you can get on your way, on your art journey. So we've got that kind of basically blocked in, which is fantastic. And it's looking pretty good. It's got a little dimension. It's got a little skin tone in there. And now it's going to be about how we take this, define and refine what we're looking at. How do we, you know, kind of resolve and finish this out a little bit more? I'm going to be altering between this, like, number 8 bright and 6's fours probably and twos, just to give me some control, because I think it's important to change your brushes when you need more control. But now we've got to start putting in the dimension, the drama, and that's always fun. So I definitely have some blue over here already to darken my brown. I can even pull a little black over to it. That's okay too. That's okay too. That side. I'm going to pull my alizarin out. Get my yellow oxide. Now you can see I'm getting kind of a deep color here. There's sort of this basic formulation to skin tones. I really wish this would not dry out on me. I'm probably going to have to put more of it out. All right, let's definitely start creating our space and dimension. I am now looking for my deepest shadows. All right, these will be darker. To make sure I'm blending that. Blending it. We'll do one with like a lot of makeup sometime. We'll just do some different studies of these. Things like eyes and noses and ears are always improved by an active study of them. Pulling this out a little bit more. I think that I'm going to definitely shade the lid here. Got a very dark line, I think, at the lid line. I think we'll take a little of the black over. Kind of knocked back with our brown. Let's come along the top line of the lid. This applies to really everything, you know, that you're painting with eyes. A lot of these structures, a lot of these shadows or high definitions. So yeah, the line is very fine here. Pulling it back, pressing down. Letting it widen. I'm going to find this back right here. Just using my glazing medium. I'm going to bring this down here a little bit. Just defining this space. Another wonderful space that I want to come in to find. I want to take a little of my blue and a little of my black. And I want to come inside along here. This is going to get knocked back a little bit. I'm going to wipe off my brush. I'm going to get a little of my glaze. I'm going to just pull this up a bit. I'm just blending and pulling it up. And it's okay if some of the shadow maybe casts out onto your lid, but I grab a little brown to do it. See, just building up what we're doing. Get a little glaze. Definitely, definitely add some shadow to what's happening over here, pulling it down. but it's just a tint. It's just barely, right? I'm starting to think about what's happening here. Let's take some of this. Put a little white into it. You can see I'm adding a little white into it. And let's create a little bit of this over here. You can see I grabbed a little brown and black. And what I'm trying to do, if you're seeing here, is I'm trying to create the shading. Because the lashes, which we're going to create a reflection from, will be also casting a shadow, and the lid will be casting a shadow, and the shape of the eye will be casting a shadow, and in those we start to see, let's grab a little black there, the shape of the eye. No, just a little bit. I think we could even pull out some of that alizarin some. So let's grab the brown and the alizarin. Let's pull that here. Make sure that we've got a nice... area. Let's get the glazing liquid. And again, make sure we don't lose our shading. Just trying to say that this is happening. Defining it up. You know, eventually this ends up with maybe a little cad and some white. The inside quite brighter. You can see that I'm putting that in there. Just trying to create what we're seeing. I'm gonna get some more white with glazing and just keep rounding it out, shading it out. You see these speed paints kind of let you know what you're in for on your realistic eye. Let's keep going. Let's keep persevering, because as we take this time and as we look at this subject and really break down where these highlights, shadows, colors, and tones are, it's going to help us even when the eyes are much smaller, knowing what we have to have in those structures to create the illumination and connection from our subject to our viewer. All right, so I'm going to keep working this because we've got to always be working. Be a painting shark. What does that mean? I don't know. I just made that up. But basically, I think what I'm saying is, like, you know, sharks have to be swimming and you need to be painting. I'm just sort of defining that little line there. And now, if you're starting to see, there is, inside the eye, a little shadow that starts to happen, like right here. And another sort of coming in one that lifts up right here. This shadow. We want to make sure that we have those shadows. Take that little shadow out a little bit. If you have to wipe your brush off a lot and glaze, definitely do that. Don't be worried about having to do that, because that's going to be an important part of what you've got going here. Glazing is happy, happy stuff. All right, so we have this here. We can create a little more definition around an eyebrow. A little brown, a little black, a little brown, a little black together. So one of the things that you can do is, you know, maybe put in another layer. More thought out little hairs. I'm working the edge of my brush. This is why brights can be a nice friend to an acrylic painter, because they have such nice lining capacity as well as painting in fields. And so you don't have to switch your brushes maybe as often. Maybe put a, you know, because there's always, you know, maybe hair got away. It happens. That's why everybody goes and gets threading or pluck their eyebrows. So, you know, you can decide how organized and well thought your brow area is. Just pulling that in. Oh yeah, it's kind of fun to do. Right there. Fun stuff. My pressure to get these lines with this brush is very light. And what works for me here is that my tools are quite good. A lot of times, you know, you can paint, you can see it in my playlist. I've painted with coffee. You can paint with anything. But it does help to have good tools. It just does. When you're trying to tell a story. So I'm just very carefully. The difference between taking this from a realistic eye to a hyper-realistic eye would be to really slow down and do this in small segments and really like observe each individual hair and the texturing of the skin and a over-examination of the subject in almost its nature. Just as something you might not know. All right, I'm going to keep working this. One of my very favorite things is to put in the shadow. So I'm going to take my blue and black and maybe add a little brown to it. And get some glaze. I'm going to come under the eye right here. I'm going to start adding in the shadow. Shadow is very, very important. This is maybe one of the number one things when I'm out that people might forget to do in their own piece. They'll paint really great eyes. I'll see them. They'll share them with me. And they're really, really good. They just don't have enough of the shadow. They want to light the whole eye. And they'll be like, why is yours working out maybe differently for you? And I can promise you it's probably in the shadow. So I'm trying to take this down at least in this first. If you divided the eye into thirds, I would say the third of it I would want to have a shadow. And then I even into the tear duct, I want to pull that shadow. I'm going to get my red. I haven't rinsed my brush at all, but I pulled it into the red, and that's going to let me come back here and do a shadow, but have a slight red cast to it, which it would have. Just would. And maybe a little more red. One more yellow. Just pulling that right here. Just a touch. Still in shadow. In this lid part. But you can see that starts to define that in some way. So I've got this sort of muddied red. I'm going to take it over to my white. Quite a bit of white to it. Start working it into the eye. Don't forget your glaze. So we're just making sure that we're shading things as we're seeing things. And you may find you've got to come back, fix, repair, restore, go back, define, This is the painting process. This should be your process. I'm just pulling these things out. Now I want to make sure my tear duct has a nice space in it. Glaze. Rinsing my brush out. Time for me to change water. I don't want my water to get too muddy as I'm doing these different tones. And one of them is going to be, I'm going to take my red over to my oxide and get kind of a pink going. Add quite a lot of white to it. Maybe put out some more glazing. Come along here and make sure that I'm lightening up this area of my lid, but that it's still quite pink. Just right up to there and blended back into here. As it blends, you can see I've kept the shadow, but then I can come back into my shadowed skin and make sure that I'm defining. Defining. Shading. It's my alizarin and my ochre. Putting in a little glaze. Just making sure that we have that in there. Maybe a little more of that. More red. Just working that out. Wiping often. A little just ochre. Haven't really rinsed my brush off. And maybe a little bit of this color dusted in. Can you see it dusting in? Makes a difference. Dust that color in. Now I want to add a bit of shadow here. So I'm going to rinse out. Maybe a little of the burnt. Just making sure that right here, I'm going to come up inside the eye here with this dark, dark, dark color. Outside the eye here with this dark, dark, dark color. Get your glaze and pull it in. This is going to start coming together very quickly now. Very, very quickly. Well, not in YouTube terms, but in art terms. super, super quickly. You can see how we're starting to really, really deepen the aspect of the eye. A little blue, black, grab that glaze, and just continuing to really, 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 really seek a shadow right here. Now it's going to get crazy when we put the reflection in. This is when this is going to just sort of go, oh, it's a magic trick. Right now, I just want to make sure that I have the darkness happening to the outside of the eye. I'm definitely, definitely going to need. Shadow, 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 shadow. Keep putting out my glazing liquid. You can do this all with dry brushing. It will have a rougher look, but it will still come out. Because what's more important than anything about what I'm doing is finding the values. I will wipe and then blend, see? Just enjoy it, if you can. All right, so now we're here. Now to help myself out, I'm gonna pull out my black. I'm going to make sure that I, right here, put that in. That's going to help me do a couple of things. It's going to let me know where I'm going with a couple of things that I'm going to do. All right. And I'm going to take even this right here, right along the lid, just this black, and shade that in. What? What am I doing? Yep, I have a reason. But not totally down. All right, so we have that happening there. Now the next thing that I've got to do is I have got to get a little of the yellow on my brush, but it's still got some blue in it. And I'm gonna pull out a lot of white. Below here, I'm going to very lightly, and this will also be a glaze, add this very bright, what you say? That's right, very bright color. Right here. It's going to come around this almost. And come back here. What's happening, you say? All kinds of things are happening. In this, I might add a pop or two of just ochre. Right here. A little bit here. Some here. I might even grab some sienna. Just a few things here. Believe it or not, this is more like a bokeh, what I have going on. It will make sense when I put its next reflection in. And I think that I want another one right here. I'll come and define more. And just a second. This is what we've got going on. We're going to let that dry. While that's going, you're going to take a little of your phthalo and maybe even your CAD and some white. Add a smidge of brown to it. We are going to start pulling out from the eye this light. Now, in a hyper-realistic piece, you would actually even do the structures inside the eye. And you could, in a camera, and I currently do, see the structures. Now, on a small piece that's not quite large, that wouldn't be really something that you would pay attention to. But if you were to take the time to study those, you would very quickly discover that they meant something to you, that they actually did impact the piece, and that there were small things that you could do. I'm going to get some yellow oxide on my brush and some white. It's going to make kind of a green. I'm going to add some of that into the structure right there. Little pops of this color. Coming in and out of the eye. Not everywhere though. See, it's just sort of feathered and happening there, and set your brush. Phthalo, blue, and brown again. You're going to notice when you work with these two that they make almost a green. So make sure that you pull that from the outer edge in. Get the glaze if you need it. The magic of the eye is in actually how colorful it really, really is. Right? So, next, I'm going to rinse my brush. This is going to be real fun. I've got this blue area right here, and I'm going to put quite a lot of white into it. And just have some of this. I'm now on the edge. That I'm going to pull into this. Not everywhere. See, I'm laying the brush. Kind of tell the story for me. Just letting it do that. Feather, 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 feather. You've got to come back with your dark. Come back with your dark. Anything that you've got to do, do the dance. Take the time. Blend it together. Make it organic is what I would say. This is actually fun stuff to do. I didn't know I was, you know, when I started on my YouTube journey, that I was going to be able to share this kind of stuff with everybody. So it's exciting to do. Now, we've got to do some shadows right here. Now I'm going to get a smaller brush that I have a lot of control over. I'm going to see if it's going to be a number 4 or number 2, but I'm going to start with a number 2. All right, let's get these eyelashes laid in with this number 2 bright and a nice fluid paint on it. I've used my gel, my glazing liquid here, to thin the paint a bit so that it'll flow off my brush smoothly so I can get refined lines. And I'm gonna use a little bit of the curve perspective to show these in the shadow. I'm going to make this very, very light in pressure, so that the lines are very, very refined. I'm going to make sure my tip of my brush, you can see me press and roll, is loaded. I'm going to just lightly brush that shadow in. You can tell how anything is lit by looking at the subject eyes. An important thing to know. If you ever want to know how somebody lit something, look at their eyes. So we have that shadow happening here. I'm going to take my number 6 bright. A little brown to it. And make sure that the lid right here is darkened. Like it might be. Just paying attention to what I am thinking about. You'll find if you start doing a study of eyes, that eyes are very different as they age. Eyes are very different as they emote. So everything you're doing here is about expressing this state of this subject. You can actually tell a lot of story in eyes. When you get good at this, then you can have fun and make all kind of crazy things happen in the eye reflections. One of my very favorite paintings I ever did is of the reflections of a cat in an owl's eyes, and the owl looks all scared. It's very, very funny. It makes me super happy when I look at it. Other owls might be like, that ain't cute. That ain't funny. I don't like that. All right, so I'm going to make sure that my black is fairly fluid, and because it's been out, it's probably gummed. My paint skins because my studio is quite dry, and so that can make it super challenging for me to do my work. And I have to sometimes put out more paint than you might have to put out just to address for that. Now I'm going to start putting up eyelashes. Eyelashes, like trees, are thicker at the base and finer at the tip. I find that having a lighter hand with these is better. It'll keep them from being gloppy. To the perspective. Sort of interesting what they do. And then here they might, they sometimes kind of come curve out like that, which is interesting to me, how they do. Eyelashes being wild creatures. So I'm curving the line down and pulling up, and that's helping me give the perspective of the foreshortened lash. And that's what we're trying to do, is say, this here is the reflection of those there. Ooh, crazy, aren't we? What are we thinking? I don't know. I come up with these ideas and I'm like, oh, let's learn how to paint a realistic eye for beginners. That's a good idea. But I think all of this stuff can be learned, and I don't think it's just intrinsically impossible for new people to take it on. I think that it's just that a certain amount of information is expected of the student that's not fair. But if you're willing to slow down and explain what you're doing, I'm going to also try to make my eyelashes a little disorderly. Right? Because I don't want them to, you know how there's always those few that just won't participate as they should with the rest of these guys. I'm going to rest this brush for a second and pull out my number 8. I really, really, really need to pull a little red, a little yellow, and quite a lot of the white here. for this highlight right here. And then this one that's underneath right here. And I may need more glaze to get it to blend as I need it to. Just want to make sure. We're telling our story as we should tell our story. Let's add a little of this kind of tinted white up here in the eyeball, and I think it's important to add it a little bit right here. Actually, it's sort of interesting because there's going to be an interesting glaze reflection that comes across here. I'm going to put a little more glaze so I can do it. I don't want my pigment at my full strength. I want it to just be able to sort of create a milky coating over here for this part of the reflection. Very, very, very milky. And then there's a little bit here. I don't want to lose all that work I did in the eye, though. And that's what the glaze is for. Creating this incredible lighting drama that's actually happening right here. And a little more out into the eye, as it would have. You kind of see that going on. And while I've got this, I'm going to create this stronger little light that would be happening. We've got this one right here above the eye. And a couple going on around the lashes. Right in between there. See them? Cool, right? I think so. I think very cool when that's going on, when we show those moments. More glaze. Put too much white down. See, I'm just lifting it back up using the glaze. Helps me. So, there we go. Here is shadow and highlight. Now we've got to talk about some lashes down here. And some highlights inside the eye. So lashes down below aren't particularly different. I mean, they're not completely, not like they're upstairs cousins. They tend to be a little lighter and finer. So I really get very soft with where I'm planting them. I know they're going to be mostly growing out of the lid line, and that also helps me define some lid line stuff that I have going on. Some will be very defined and some will not. I pay attention to how they might curve. I always like that some of them will do things like this. They'll curve this crazy way. So I'm just, what's happening there? What can I convey in what I'm doing? The eye is a bit to me in art like the egg is to chefs. I mean, you can really make an egg. You really, really are cooking, and a lot of times when you really, really work your eye, that's when you're really starting to pull your art skills together. And for a lot of people, it feels like magic when they see them happen. And I get why. I'm going to add a little red to my black here. Because I want slightly darker shadow right there. Define that a little bit. Okay. Now that that's really going, we can come here up in the brow. And we're almost done, guys, because we have the sort of a brow definition. And then really a final couple little reflections, and you will have gotten that basic understanding of what it takes to paint eyes in a more realistic fashion. So I'm super looking forward to what everybody does. I'm just adding a few more kind of thought out defined hairs here. Just to make sure that the whole piece, this whole cohesive piece, is doing well. And again, we're going to talk about this again. I'm going to post this, and you're going to say to me, oh, hey, this part was really easy, made it clear, but could you cover that part more? And we'll post more of these studies. I'm going to get a clean brush. And I might even put out some fluid paint. You could just use your white, but sometimes fluid helps me when I'm really, really trying to get a very specific thing. I've got this detail. It says number 0, multimedia brush. This paint is a little bit translucent, but in this particular case, that's how I want it to be. And I'm going to just, in the eye here, a little bit above the shadow, add some pure white. Some little dots of pure white there. I'm gonna pull it out from the shadow here, so I'll knock that back a little bit. I want that shadow back. Give me my shadow back. Shadow facts. So I'll just paint that back in. We don't wanna lose that shadow. Not for any reason. And we're going to take a little more of this and come along here above the shadow line, adding that high white highlight. And then just a couple in here. Lining some of those out so that they really pop. All kinds of places you can sign a painting. I think you should, you know, always stop and think about where you're signing it and why you're signing it where you are, if you're going to sign. And I'm going to be a little bit cheeky and sign in here. But very muted, so you have to look for it. You can see that I'm not really making it pop. It's just sort of lightly there. If I did it any darker, it would disrupt the piece. But like this, it becomes just sort of part of the overall composition. So we did that. We painted a realistic eye in acrylic painting. Step by step, hopefully I've explained this to you. Hopefully I have made it easier to understand how this is done, and you're just kind of like, dude. And this isn't hyper-realism by any means. This is an eye that isn't abstracted. I haven't tried to distort it. I'm painting the tonal values that I see, and I'm trying to represent it to you reasonably accurately. But you can see that we've covered a lot of those things that make an object feel more realistic and make an object feel like it exists in our space. I hope you enjoyed painting along with me. I really want to see all your paintings. Send me your eyeballs. I want to just fill up social media with eyeballs. If you'd like more information, you can remember, always check in the description below, in the iCard, at theartsherpa.com, and you can find me anywhere and just ask a question. We have lives 3 times a week that you can come and be like, hey, what's going on with this? And I'm like, probably gonna know. So you guys be good to yourselves, be good to each other. I hope you keep painting. I hope you're blown away by what you're capable of. And I want to see you at the easel really soon. Bye-bye.